at the monastery, he said. Italy was hot, he said. And it's rain, Mr. Croup. Rain.
That, Mr. Vandemar, is going to be a very fine conflagration. When it conflagrates. Although I doubt that any of the inhabitants are in a position entirely to appreciate it.
Well, because of being dead.
Because, as you so wisely point out, of being dead. Barrel of lamp oil.
Somebody not dead. Is now.
Our work here is done, Mr. Vandemar.
What's next?
500 years north from here, London.
Kill people?
Oh, yes. I certainly think I can guarantee that.
Just a wee breath of fresh air. It won't be a minute. Whoa.
Oh, laddie, you can't stay there. They'll move you on or take you in. Trust me, I know.
No. I'm not begging. I just came out for air. It's my leaving party in there, you see. Got a present and everything.
Oh, that is a very white umbrella.
Huh?
What's it say on it?
It's a map, I think. Oh, no, look, it's the London Underground. It's nice.
Oh, London, I've been there. Hey, give me your hand. I'll tell you a fortune.
No, I haven't got any chance. Hey.
Oh, you have a long way to go.
Yeah, I said London.
Not just London, not the London I know. Oh, here we go, rain.
Take the umbrella.
Are you sure?
Aye, it doesn't really suit me anyway. Not for a big job in the city.
You've got a good heart. Sometimes that's enough to see you safe wherever you go, but mostly it's not. It starts with doors. I'd watch out for doors if I were you.
Right, great. Thanks a lot. Cheers.
Neverwhere by Neil Gaiman. Episode 1. London Below.
Jangling toy. Onward.
Is that you, Gary?
Richard, where are you?
Well, as it's nearly 4 o'clock, I decided I'd go and get some lunch. And now I am back in the building.
Sylvia's doing her nut. The MD needs a Wandsworth report on his desk ASAP.
I'm on my way up.
And Mr. Mayhew, I need to see your pass.
Mr. Figgis, you know who I am. You knew who I was when I left 3 minutes ago.
People can't be coming in and out willy-nilly. They could have computers, potted palms or carpets concealed about them.
Right,
I'm paid to scan their ID cards, and scan them I shall.
Here. Same person as this morning.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
You're in trouble.
Yeah, I'm on it. Thank you, Gary.
Richard, I hate to chase.
Yeah, but you need the Wandsworth report.
The managing director is leaving early for his golf weekend.
5 minutes, Sylvia. Just have to attach the P&L projection, OK?
Thank you.
No problem.
Oh, and if you see a sand wedge...
Yep, I'll tell him where to shove it.
Cutting it fine?
Oh, crap. I've lost Appendix C.
Look there.
What?
No, there.
Ah, right, thanks.
Are we slow for drinks? Big week coming up. We can go over the Mersham account. Tonight, 6:30.
I am all over it,
Managing Director Secretary.
Sylvia, it's Richard. The report should be printing off in your machine any time now.
You're an angel, Richard. Thank you.
No worries, darling.
Angels.
Richard Mayhew.
Richard, it's Jessica.
Jessica, hello, darling. What's up?
You've forgotten, haven't you?
Forgotten? No, I hadn't forgotten. 7 p.m. at Mummy's on. See you there, Jess.
Jessica, Richard, and no Richard. We'll meet at your flat and walk down together. You've confirmed the reservation?
Yeah, absolutely.
6:30, main front door. Wear a suit.
All right, why?
If I need to make an impression on Arnold Stockton, so does my fiancé.
We're taking Arnold Stockton to dinner?
The point is to get me the job organising the exhibition of his angel collection.
Ah, yeah, angels. That was it. Right, Jessica, I don't know...
Good, see you at 6:30.
I'm getting our drinks off.
Man, I am so dead.
Not surprised. She terrifies me.
Jessica remains the light and love of my life, thank you very much for asking.
How does a laid-back, floppy-haired Scot roll up in London and pull a posh bird like her?
Dumb luck, huge... Nah, look, Gary, I have blown it. I'm really sorry. We're taking our boss out to dinner tonight at Ma Maison.
Arnold Stockton?
Yeah.
Ma Maison?
Mm-hmm.
Blimey. Have you reserved a table?
Oh, hell! Which note was it?
You'll never get in.
Man, this is a matter of life and death, and I'm going to make it happen.
Ma maison?
Hello?
Can I help you?
It's just possible you could save my life.
Getting warm, Mr. Croup.
Temple Notch, give me wings.
Did I do shorts? No. Right, what have I forgotten? Jacket, phone, trousers. Hang on. It's Ellie. What is it with her?
It's Jessica. I hope you're ready.
I'm just doing my... Yeah, Jessica. I'll be right down. You could have come up to the flat.
I'd rather not.
Well, I tidied up.
It never seems to make much difference.
I know. You know something? You're beautiful. What are you doing with a guy like me?
Don't be silly. We need to hurry.
Right, okay. Well, let's get a cab.
On an evening like this, we walk. Come along.
Yes, Jessica.
Hurts. Hurts so much.
Wait. This way, Mr. Vandemar. If the taste of her blood is to be believed...
Blood to be relished, Mr. Croup.
Soon, very soon, she's slowing up.
Spare any change?
Now, when you meet Arnold Stockton tonight, remember, he's not only a very important man, he is a corporate entity in his own right.
I can't wait, Jess.
Don't call me that, Richard. I loathe pet names. They are so demeaning.
Sorry.
Spare any change? Homeless and hungry?
Yeah. Hang on a minute.
Richard, we don't have time.
Oh, come on, he's down and out.
I give to charity, and I invest ethically.
Yeah, catch Paul.
Got it. Thanks, Gav.
Now, it's vital that my future spouse makes a good impression.
Yeah. It doesn't sound like you think I can.
Don't be silly. There wasn't any problem with the reservation, was there?
Bless me, Mr. Vandemar. The girl must be losing a lot of blood after you caught her with the old toad sticker.
Lovely blood. Lovely, wet blood.
Very close now, we are.
And my blade is ready.
Oh, bless my little black soul, Mr. Vandemar. Do you see what I see at the end of that spur?
A wall, Mr. Croup.
A wall with a little lost girl leaning on it. And no way out.
No exit.
I pray to my dead parents, to the temple and the arch.
I spy with my little eye something that's going to be
dead as the rest of her family, Mr. Croup.
If this is the last door I open, may it be to somewhere safe. Somebody.
Our principal will be delighted.
Domini ostia memorat vobis patron seri.
She's going through!
Well, bugger and blast.
An extra £50 for a late booking? You should have told them it was for Arnold Stockton.
Yeah. I'm sorry, Jessica, but that girl, she just appeared.
What girl?
On the pavement.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.